What's going on, guys? Johnny here, and we're back for CPC Season 5. This time it's Week 8. We're taking on Aberforth again. We played him last season, and he's probably one of the best coaches in the league, apart from Gypsy King and Joost Bartels, or at least what I consider to be the best coaches in the league. Now that Rob left, as always, he is one of the most threatening hyper, if not the most threatening hyper offense player in draft league format, and I think his team this season reflects that perfectly. I'm definitely looking forward to playing him again. It's always like a double-edged sword. On the one hand, I'm always looking to prove myself against the best. On the other hand, approaching the matchup versus Ape, I'm super super scared. Plus, I didn't really have that much time prepping for him this week. I was pretty pressed for time. So I'm not as confident in my team build as I probably should be approaching this match. But yeah, looking at the matchup first, his team consists of Z Victini. He actually changed that, so it's not Z Terrakion. So Z Victini, Swallow, Superior, Terrakion, Rotom Wash, Comfy, Steelix, Omastar, Zygarde 10%, Mega Tyranitar. My team has changed a bit as well. I dropped Aerodactyl and Tornadus Eye in favor of Tyranitar and regular Gallade, and made Gallade his second Z-move user. This had various reasons, but mostly was like a matchup dependent choice, and Arrow and Torn weren't really like, while I like the speed on the team, they didn't really give me the bulky offense or didn't really complement the draft in the way I wanted them to. So we have looking at his team, Victini is a giant threat to my team. I do have the T-Tar to deal with it, but I want to deal with it more effectively. I should bring Scarf, but Sub Victini is something that can really realistically come, and it terrifies me. Suicune can also deal with it, but Z Victini with like Z Bolt Strike is really tough to deal with. We have Swallow, which I can handle quite well. It might still come because it outspeeds my entire team and can pressure it a bit, but Spadef, Mew, Mega Scizor, Stunfisk, T-Char can all deal with Swallow to an extent. Superior is what I consider to be the biggest threat to my team, just because my grass resists are all weak to fire, and to get up a Leaf Storm or Subseed, I have really big problems beating this Superior. The only good thing is that it can't run Scarf reliably versus my team, which means that I can rely on a Scarfer to actually beat it. Terrakion, if it comes, is something I definitely expect to beat Choice Scarf to deal with my Volcarona. And Rotom Wash is the other big threat to my team. My electric check is Stunfisk, which doesn't appreciate water moves, and it also has a solid check. Is a solid check to Scizor. It can trick the Suicune. It can sort of beat the Volcarona. Tanks a hit from the Scolipede, so I need to find a way to build around this Rotom and beat it reliably. Next up is Comfy, which I don't think is the biggest threat to my team right now. Reconsidering, I might be a bit underprepared for it, to be honest. I do have some poison and steel coverage on my team, but my Muse, I don't really anticipate Comfy to come, because in between Mega Scissors Bullet Punch, in between Scolipede, which outpaces and has for Lion Drain Punch, Draining Kiss, Volcarona can't really beat. Muse too bulky to beat it. Can't even beat Gallade reliably. So I'm not sure if Comfy will come, but we'll see about that. Steelix is interesting. If it comes, it's going to be a raw variant with rocks and a defense to and potentially Chukabray to deal with my Scolipede. I'm not sure otherwise. Omastar probably lead hazards. I kind of have to prevent the Omastar from getting more than one form of hazards on me, which is something I'm definitely planning to do. Zygarde 10%, I can deal with rather well with Mew, Suicune, and Mega Scizor, so I'm not really that worried about Zygarde. And he might still bring it for E-Speed support to deal with my Scolipede. And last but not least, the Mega Tyranitar, which is just an enormous threat. I do have ways of dealing with the Dragon Dance variant rather reliably, so like a Scarf, Mien Shao, like a Bullet Punch, Mega Scizor. So I expect it more to be like an adamant bulky tar, but even that can be dealt with to an extent by my Mew. The one other set I'm kind of worried about is Rock Polish, but then that really does lack a bit of attack to beat my team if it's not severely weakened down. But yeah, that's the team matchup. So let's hop right into the team I brought. And here we are. I brought a Choice Scarf Mien Shao. As I said, it's a good revenge killer for his entire team. deals well. A revenge is pretty much everything barring a Scarf Dragon, and even that, if it's locked into Stone Edge, doesn't kill me, so I'm in a good position. Next up, I brought a Spadef bulk upgrade, fast enough for certain Rotoms and for Jolly Mega Titar. This thing is sub bulk up. It just, and Drain Punch, and I think Poison Chap, it just beats his team. If I get into the right position, this does beat down his team, because once I get a bulk up, Victini doesn't beat me, Swallow doesn't do too much to me, and I can always recover that back with Drain Punch. I beat the Mega T-Tar. I can actually potentially sub up on the Rotom depending on his spread, and also I can beat Comfy 1v1. So yeah, that's pretty nice. SD Scolipede, no, I'm not SD, I think. Am I? Yes, I am SD. I'm SD Scolipede with Spikes, Mega Horn, and Earthquake. Because that basically hits his entire team for neutral, super effective damage. We have the Mega Scizor, which is just an offensive Mega Scizor with SD, because Bullet Punch is really what I'm going to be going for this game. We have a Chopperberry T-Tar to deal with the Victini, sort of. And we have a Spadef Mew with U-Turn, Heal Bell, Roost, and... U-Turn, Heal Bell, Roost, and Will-O-Wisp. Will-O-Wisp actually cripples the T-Tar and makes me beat it 1v1. Yeah. And looking at lead matchup, I brought the Scarf Mianchao and specifically Evita to outspeed it. Omastar at +2, so Mianchao is my dedicated lead here because I expect him to lead Omastar. I can 2KO him with the high jump pick, even if he gets the weak armor boost, and basically limit him from getting more than one form of hazards up versus me. So that's exactly what I'm going to do, as he decides to get up his stuff, Rock, which is something I'm completely fine with. I can just go for the high jump kick, get some good damage off on this Victini, and here's the first thing. It's always like this. I know how A plays, right? A plays super aggressively. He knows I'm going to switch into T-Tar here, so I'm like, I can go to Mew here and eat the hit. But then again, I always convince myself to not make the play. I think last season it was something with my Latios versus his Gardevoir, and he had the Swallow in the back, and I almost clicked Draco Meteor, but I couldn't will myself to do it. Well, here's the thing. I could go Mew now, predicting the fighting move, to predicting him, predicting my Tyranitar. I don't do it, and he clicks Brick Break, chops my Chocolberry, and now my T-Tar isn't a check to his Victini anymore. Yikes. That's a good time, right? No, it isn't, I know. He can just Brick Break me again, but the good thing is I get half off his Victini, so Scizor is looking in a pretty good shape here late game. I can just go with my Scolipede. I protect to get some more Sandstorm chip on it, because this is actually a max HP Victini. And now I can click Earthquake to try and revenge, try and kill this Victini as he sacks off his Omastar, which is a fair play because he wasn't sure if I would click Mega Horn here. Now he sends out his Rotom, which can take any hit, but as I mentioned before, Rotom is a big threat to my team, and it severely annoys like Mew, and it severely annoys Scizor. If I can weaken this Rotom enough and get some more chip on the Victini, Mega Scizor actually is in a fantastic position to sweep up late game. So I decide to just pull my Z move here. It should do a solid 60-70% to this Rotom. Savage Man, as you can see, I crit him, so that's really unfortunate, but it's the game we play. There's really nothing I can do here. So yeah, I'm just gonna get my next speed boost as he goes into Swallow, and here it doesn't really pay off that I didn't bring Poison Jab, because if I had brought Poison Jab over Spikes, I could have won this game here. But no, as I'm going to scout what he looks himself into, because most Swallows are Specs, and then I go into my Scizor, which is a rather safe play. I can take two Boom Bursts once I Mega up, and just Roost off the damage, so I'm really in a good spot here. However, as you'll see, and I don't think this is risking my win con, which is what I meant to say, because Scizor is definitely win con at this point. Yeah, as you can see, he crits me back, so there's some justice. I don't think this mattered a bit more, because I did click Bullet Punch here, which was a bad play on my part. I should have roosted up, predicting him to switch out here. But just in case he just decided to kill my Scizor, I wanted to be able to roost up. But if he had gone Boomers, I still had means of beating the Swallow nonetheless, so Roost here should have been my play. Unfortunately, I don't make the play, and because I'm at 11%, I can't switch back into Rock, so there's really no point to save the Scizor. And this right here means that I lost my biggest win con this game for no actual reason. This also means this misplay, because I brought this passive Mew that only has U-Turn as a coverage move. that Comfy is looking like a ridiculous threat right now, and I don't have Poison Jab on my Scolipede. Only way I can beat Comfy now is with a Poison Jab blade. So that's definitely a prep mistake on my part, and a choke that on my end that I didn't roost with Scizor here, or that I even risked Scizor switching into the Boom Burst when I still had options like a Spidev Mew that, looking at his team, doesn't do that much apart from burning the Mega T-Tar. So yeah, I'm really not happy with how I played this. And yeah, he V-creates me, gets the speed drop, finally revealing that he's not Choice Scarf, I think. But Mian Shao is just a safe thing. I can just U-turn out here and go into my Gallade, I think, because Gallade actually takes on all three of his remaining Pokemon. He goes into Swallow. Best thing he can do is Air Slash me. As you see, that the 64 by to recover a lot back with Drain Punch and can 2KO him safely. But since that is revealed to be Specs, I go into my Mew because that actually chews it a bit better and preserves health on my Gallade, which, as I mentioned, is my best thing to take on the Comfy now. And I will Wisp here, and now I'm in the position, what am I doing? I can U-turn here, predicting his Calm Mind or Synthesis, and go into my Mian Shao to click Poison Jab and weaken it that way. He goes for the HP Fire, predicting my Scolipede, so good play on him, and Ape's aggressive nature showing a bit. I go for Poison Jab. This is zero to the Megatar, so but I can't really mess around with Comfy at this point. I go into my Gallade, which is another bad play. I should have just stayed in here, or sacked my Scolipede and preserved Gallade, because Gallade was actually, as I mentioned, my only way of taking on the Comfy. So yeah, I'm really not happy with how I played this game. I think there was some really errors in my prep, but now my whole team is beaten by Comfy. There's really not much I can do. I can still try to stall it a bit with Mew, and in case it's not Calm Mind, which I don't think it is, it's Ape, he's going to run a setup move, I just lose to it. And he doesn't know that. He plays a bit more carefully, predicting my Scolipede and all that, because I could still have Poison Jab and that would actually still beat the Comfy, but I don't, because I have Spikes. So yeah, I'm going to lose this game to the Comfy. I will be able to beat the Mega T-Tar first though, because Ape is not going to unnecessarily risk his Pokemon here. He put me in guaranteed range here, and now I'm just he can just Draining Kiss to finish me off, and then he can Draining Kiss my Mian Shao and proceed to beat my Mew 1v1. So yeah, that's good game to Ape. I'm really not happy with how I prepped and how I played this game. I think I did have a bit of a matchup advantage. If I had played to the best of my ability, I definitely could have won this game. Preserving Gallade, not sucking Scizor, bringing or not making the read on the Victini and going hard Mew to U-turn instead of going hard T-Tar, because the U-turn would have actually allowed me to guarantee Pursuit Trap the Victini, which is something. Yeah, it's pretty unfortunate. I'm not happy. It's kind of a theme this season that I play a good game, then play a bad game, or I just bring Suicune and win. So that's something as well. But yeah, still good game to Abe. It's always a fun playing him. He's really chill. I really like his attitude and how he plays. I just still need to really commit to me counter styling and playing him the way I should. But yeah. GG to Ape. That was week 8 of CPC Season 5. We'll be back next week with CPC Season 5, week 9. Which, and yeah, until then, GG guys. Cheers. I'm out.